Hi viewer, I welcome you to Dim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through business studies from 3, lesson number 5. The topic is demand and supply. I'm your tutor, Lucy Mudon. Welcome. Let us look at our lesson objectives. Today we are going to look at the supply schedule and the demand curve. So by the end of the lesson, the learner should be able to draw a supply curve, but when it is an omission, supply curve from a supply schedule. Today we are dealing with supply schedule and supply curve. Supply schedule. A supply schedule is a curve showing the quantity supplied at a specific price at a particular time. An example, we have the price of the book and the quantity that was supplied. We have, when it is at 300, the quantity that was supplied was 30. When it is at 250, the quantity supplied it is at 25. When it is at 200, the quantity supplied it is at 20. When it is at 150, the quantity supplied it is 15. When it is 100, the quantity supplied it is 10. And when it is 50, what is supplied it is 5. If at all you look at that supply schedule, it is an illustration that when the prices are increasing, the quantity that is supplied also is up. And when the prices of this book have decreased, then it means that even its supply is going down. So in that case, that what happens when we are talking about a supply schedule. Let us look at the supply curve. This is the graphical representation of the information that is contained in the supply schedule. So there is an omission there. It is supposed to be supply schedule. It is drawn by plotting the price of the commodity against the quantity of a commodity supplied. That one tells us the price. It is on the y-axis, while the quantity it is on the x-axis. Draw the supply curve based on the supply schedule below. You have the prices and quantity that was supplied. Price it is 5, 10, 20, and 25. On the other side, the quantity supplied it is 5, 25, 50, and 100 respectively. This is the way it's supposed to be. When you look at the price, we said that price is supposed to be on the y-axis and the quantity supplied is supposed to be on the x-axis. So in that case now, you are going to get that the supply curve is going to move from the left-hand side to the right-hand side, as you can be able to see from that illustration. From the supply curve, it can be noted that the quantity supplied increases with increase in price. The quantity supplied increases with increase in price. That is one condition. This is called the law of supply. So, in case you are trying to state the law of supply, supposed to be the quantity supplied increases with increase in price. Number two that we can get from the curve. The curve slope from right to the left. So it will slope from the right to the left. Hence, its gradient is positive. So when it comes to finding the gradient here, it is positive. It is not like the demand curve, which was just a curve. Assignment. Indicate by writing a demand or supply whether each of the following factors influence demand or supply of a commodity. Changes in the prices of inputs, change in tests, changes in technology, changes in outcomes, changes in price of other related and preferences. reference, get the KEB 2011 Invent a Secondary Business Student Book 3, that edition. If at all you want to get us, you can get us through the SMS to the number. You can also get us from the YouTube. You can also get us through the Facebook, and you can Twitter us. Stay tuned to LMTV. Thank you.